रोटी बनाना सीख ले वरना पछताएगी छोरी. That's what my mom told me a few years back. Today I tell her, रोटी तो बनानी सीख ली माँ, आओ बनाते हैं बिस्कोटी. If you survived this poem of mine, I think by now you know that we're making a biscotti. This is an almond butter biscotti, no oil required, but this rolling pin is definitely required. So let's see what all we need to make this one. So first and foremost, we need sugar here. This is half a cup of sugar which is going in. Some almond butter.
We would require around 3 to 4 tablespoon of almond butter. This looks good. Some cinnamon powder. And then I try and give this a good whisk.
Don't worry if this is not all coming together like mine is not. We can just use some plant-based milk or water. Just a little bit. So I've got coconut milk here. Some flax seeds here. And some more milk. These are our wet ingredients, we shall set them aside now. And then we look into our dry ingredients. 1 cup of whole wheat flour here. And then half a cup of ground oats. So these are just regular oats. And then you grind them, make them like an oatmeal. Pinch of salt. Half a teaspoon baking soda. And half a teaspoon of baking powder. We give all of this a good whisk. So now time to combine everything together, our dry ingredients into our wet ones. And then use your hands. So this is a little bit too dry. And so here we can go back to our coconut milk. Alright, so to get this all together into a dough like this, I ran out of my coconut milk and I'm using little bit of water. I'm being really, really careful because like I said, we don't want a very, very wet and sticky dough. We want it all nicely combined. Yep. So, your final product has to be something like this. So this is how the dough should look after all the kneading, and now comes in our rolling pin. I've taken this parchment paper here just so that nothing goes wrong. Sprinkling some wheat flour here. And then we press it like nicely. Bringing in our rolling pin and dust this also with a little bit of wheat flour. And then we roll it equally from all sides. Make sure that your edges are nice and smooth. That's really, really important. Alright then, so our oven is preheated at 200 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes and then we bake this. So this goes in at 180 degrees Celsius for around 20 to 22 minutes. Okay, so it's 20 minutes now and
We let this cool completely like for around 15 minutes and then we slice it.
Today I want to give a big shout out to Chana. When I posted a written recipe on Everyday Vegan, she was one of the first two people who tried it and it went terribly wrong for her. So that time I promised her, you know, that I'll make a video, and now we're making one. I hope you see this, Chana, and finally go make your biscotti correctly. Please share pictures with me if you do bake.
So guys, take a closer look. All these edges are really hard by now and the middle is very nice and soft. So now we'll slice these.
So this is the slicer I have, and this is so cute, specially made for Five Missions, our production house.
Lovely. This is the thickness we are looking at. Okay, so by now I'm very sure that the oven must have cooled down because it's been 15 to 20 minutes. So please preheat your oven again for 10 minutes. And here we got to flip sides so that we get really nice toasted biscottis. So now this goes in to bake for another 10 minutes. Make a note, that's at 180 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. So guys, it's 10 minutes now and all we have to do is flip sides. It's okay if they break, don't get too hyper about it because you're not going to pop in such a long biscotti inside your mouth, right? And then quickly for 10 more minutes.
And ladies and gentlemen, our wait is over, our biscotti is ready, let's see. Really, really, really hot currently. Nice and crisp. All the cinnamon gives you a really nice flavor in your mouth, and I really like cinnamon. The oats add a lot to the crunchiness. So please make your own biscotti. If you make one, put up a picture, tag me, tag Everyday Vegan, and please, it will show us a lot of support. We'll see you another time in another recipe. You take care, bye bye.